During the years he worked on Die Meistersinger, Wagner continued to lead a precarious existence. No one would stage Tristan or his first Ring operas, and his earliest works were still savaged by the critics. Although he earned some income as a conductor, he consistently lived beyond his means, even when well paid, and often had to fend off creditors. He moved to Paris for 2 years, then an amnesty allowed him to briefly move back to Germany. His wife finally left him for good, and he moved on alone to Vienna. His dreams of having his operas produced in a manner he envisioned seemed hopelessly out of reach. In 1864, after a year in Vienna, he had to flee to Switzerland, again in order to avoid arrest for his debts. He was 51 years old. But at this apparently dark hour of his life, Wagner found a savior of sorts. Ludwig II, the young king of Bavaria, had developed a fanatical reverence for the composer of Tannhäuser and Lohengrin. He now offered Wagner virtually unlimited support, which was a foolish thing to do with Wagner. He eventually took the country to near financial ruin. King Ludwig paid the composer's debts, presented him with a generous annual stipend, commissioned the completion of the Ring cycle, and arranged for the first performance of Tristan and Isolde in Munich in 1865. He then subsidized a production of Die Meistersinger in 1868. Both operas were conducted by a brilliant musician named Hans von Bülow. He had been Wagner's protege and devoted acolyte for some years, but this did not grant him immunity from the composer's indiscretions. Soon after von Bülow had followed Wagner to Munich, Wagner began an open affair with von Bülow's wife, Cosima. Interestingly, she was also the daughter of Wagner's old friend, Franz Liszt. Von Bülow ignored his wife's affair even as she bore the composer 2 children. Cosima finally left her husband in 1868 to live with Wagner. Mina had died in the meantime, and when von Bülow granted Cosima a divorce, she and Wagner were married in 1870. Cosima proved the most devoted of all Wagner's followers. She recorded his thoughts and deeds in a voluminous diary, and after his death, she preserved and controlled his artistic legacy with single-minded determination. She bore the composer 3 children in all, Isolde, Eva, and Siegfried, all named after leading characters in her husband's operas. Not surprisingly, von Bülow abandoned Wagner's cause and went over to the Brahms camp. He conducted the first performances of a number of Brahms's late orchestral scores and generally became the composer's most valuable advocate. He remained remarkably charitable to his ex-wife, however, and even tried to comfort her in her grief when Wagner died. Wagner returned to his Ring cycle in 1869 and completed it in 1874, a quarter of a century after he first began writing it. Now he turned his full attention to realizing the final step in his idea of the Gesamtkunstwerk, the creation of a special site for the performance of the cycle. This, he hoped, would lend presentations of his work the air of a quasi-religious festival, not unlike the drama festivals of ancient Greece. During the 1870s, he raised money from around the world and had a special theater constructed to his specifications in the Bavarian town of Bayreuth. There, the Ring cycle was presented for the first time in 1876 during a festival devoted to its production.